wheelchair prophet. Tonight we're going to bring to you a prophetic word that was given to the wheelchair prophet here in St. Louis City, Missouri, to speak to Hiller Moe. The prophetic word to District Attorney in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Hiller Moe. You listen for yourself and see if it's God that's talking or is it me. I'm going to tell you that God told me to tell him to let the boy go. Come together and seek a cure for cancer for Bernadine Moore and Latoya's hat's precious granny. Let him go.
Somewhere we'll soon make a change. We all a part of God's great big family. And the truth, you know, love is all we
thank you. Richard Carl.
Yes, my name is Mark Anthony Wooden Sr. That's my government issue. I'm calling you from St. Louis City, Missouri.
And
yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. And I'm calling for Hilla Moore.
Okay, just one second. District Attorney's Office, Linda speaking.
Hi, Linda. How are you doing today, madam?
I'm doing good.
That's wonderful. My name is Mark Anthony Wooden Sr. I believe I've spoken to you before about a year ago, Miss Linda. I'm the wheelchair prophet, and I'm and I've also, since my contact with Hilla Moore ministerially, I've left him on my email address, and he should, at least if you haven't read him or not, I at least sent it to him. Everything that I've been involved in this matter for justice and unenumerated rights for our community, I have sent it to him in regards to LaTorrance. And I spoke with Hilla Moore, and I thank him. He allowed me, and you transferred me to him over a year ago, and you allowed me to speak with Hilla Moore, or he allowed me to speak to him. Now, that was a private conversation, and I'm calling him today because of that conversation. And is it possible that I could speak with him? He's aware of that conversation. You can let
me. He's not in at the moment. I could take a message and email him.
It would not be proper for me to give a private conversation of such a manner that I had with Mr. Moore.
Okay, you can leave a message and I could pass that along to Hiller.
Well, you tell Hiller Moore. When I say tell, I use the word T-E-L-L, not because I have authority. I'm nobody. But God, who gives him breath, and God that blessed his mother and healed her and brought her in heaven with him. Now, I might sound silly to you, but Hilla Moore know what I'm talking about. You see, Hilla Moore's mother, Miss Bernadette Moore, and LaTorrance Hatch's grandmother, both died of cancer. Hilla Moore know what he need to do. It's called Susan G. Coleman. He need to do something with that young man's life and help him. He know that. Listen, if LaTorrance is guilty of these crimes that it is alleged that he's guilty of, then when you litigate the case, it'll come out. Until then, Hilla Moore need to do what he know he need to do. And I'm calling him because God impressed my heart. It's been a year. I haven't called you, madam. You tell Hilla Moore, I'm a man of God. I'm a die for mine. And that don't mean no killing nobody. That means I'm committed all the way until my last breath to stand and speak truth to people when I'm impressed to give them that. And I did that with Mr. Moore, and I ain't called him. And God impressed my heart to call him today. Now, Lil Boosie, pled to these charges of the drugs in jail. Now, but Lil Boosie also, and I observed this outside of the court, his cousin spoke and said, Lil Boosie helps the community. Hilla Moore need to do what all of our correctionals and all of our prosecutors is. We prosecute him, put him in jail, but we try to rehabilitate him. He need to get his hands dirty and try to help the kid. It's been a battle back and forth between him and LaTorrance Hatch. Lil Boosie, Hilla Moore needs to take this situation, take responsibility, and disseminate his excellence to this kid. This is a project for Hilla Moore. He know what's up. And I'm calling him again. I ain't called him, and I stand on it. My social security number is 488-728-635. Ain't nothing changed. I'm still the man of God, despite of what they've been trying to do here in the city of St. Louis by marking my character and personality, as you well know, because I've emailed Hilla Moore everything that's went down since I spoke to him, and I'm calling him now. And I'm sitting here in St. Louis City waiting on my wheelchair to get fixed. And the good Lord prompted my heart to call him and tell him he needs to do what God told him to do, and that's to battle to find the cure for cancer. I'll tell you what God told him, madam, to battle to find the cure for cancer with Lil Boosie. And the reason why the wheelchair prophet called him, because Lil Boosie and Hilla Moore got something in common, cancer. It took Lil Boosie's grandmother and it took his mother, and he need to do something. We need to come together in our community. That's what's wrong with us now. We ain't healing. We need need to quit fighting and work together. And Hiller Moore got an opportunity to take his lemons and make them lemonade. If Boosie's guilty, then Hiller Moore do his job. But otherwise than that, Hiller Moore need to do what God told him to. And you tell him Mark Anthony wouldn't sing you. And I'm here in St. Louis City, Missouri. 4887-2865, the man of God. Been preaching since I was 15, ordained in two states. I'm not no quack. And I've been very patient. I think I've been humble. And I haven't called him or harassed him or disrespected him. So I want you to know you don't have no kook on the phone. This is what I'm trying to tell you. I ain't no kook. I ain't no religious fanatic or anything of this nature. He and Lil Boosie need to work together first to show that we can come over negative energy in relationships. Second, to find a cure for cancer, to bring us together, to bring Baton Rouge together, to bring Lil Boosie and the people that's in his I guess lifestyle, these gangster rappers, whoever. Okay, you tell Hiller Moore that Mr. Wooden called, and I'm using my government issue by Mr. Wooden, but my responsibility why I'm calling this highly educated, highly powerful man is because God spoke to my heart and said that Hiller Moore and LaTorrence Hatch should work together to find a cure for cancer on behalf of his mom and Lil Boosie's grandmother. And Lil Boosie, he's in drug rehab. Hopefully he'll get better. And with Hiller Moore helping him and disseminating some of all of the kind excellence that he have, maybe y'all can make Baton Rouge and the murder rate down there and relationships with these kids a little bit better when y'all try to talk and come together and be diplomatic. Because I know Boosie's done said things to upset Hiller Moore, and Hiller Moore probably done upset Boosie, and y'all need to settle this and come to a table. Let the law be the law, but Hiller Moore know what he need to do. Now, if the man guilty and y'all got the case and y'all prosecute the man, oh well. But that ain't got nothing to do with what Hiller Moore's supposed to do. Would you please tell him I called?
Yes, sir, I will.
Okay, and I have this conversation recorded. Hello? All right. Call her back. That was me calling Hiller Moore, the wheelchair prophet. Told him what he need to do, keeping it 100 in the paint. We out.
Yeah, this Lil Boosie Badass. And this next song is for my grandma. We gonna call this one Granny Granny. Cause I miss you. Your cheering miss you. Your grand cheering miss you. Your great grand cheering miss you. Your sisters miss you. And your brother miss you. So, we finna do it like this. Grandma, I love you. Rest in peace.
I'm gonna do this for my grandma. I miss you so much. Hurt the boys, hurt the whole fam. Now I'm living like the past, I don't care.
give a damn, itching for killing. Trying to get me some healing, 10 million would make me happy. All I want is my granny. Her and mama the only one understand that a funeral ain't even came yet.
Fucked up.
And my legs weak. Ain't no screws in my head, boy, don't play with me. I'm stressing.
Fuck it.
I'm missing.
Fuck it.
I'm cursing God, I probably never get a blessing. Fuck it. She used to wake me up for school and iron my clothes. Only one can calm me down when my temper explodes. It's cold. And I'm losing it, man. Got a chopper in my name, ready to swing that thing. You don't feel how I feel, I can't maintain. Pass the door, you little nigga, I'm fucked up in the frame. Granny, 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 granny. Why you had to take me mama away? Momo, I'm going crazy. I'm all fucked up. I'm going crazy. I'm all fucked up. I'm going crazy. I'm going crazy. I'm all for the kisses on the cheek.
Thank you.
The manners that you taught me and all the love you brought me. For the pain that I brought you from that weed in the house. 50 P's in the house. Who's to get that shit out? I used to sleep in the bed with her till I was 16. Let her stash 100 G's, she ain't take one thing. So I'm asking God why you had to take Momo. Her and I am one year, I can't take no more. And the pictures make me break down. I ain't ready for this life, but you're not around. Nah, I'm smoking weed in front of the cops now.
Hey,
8 K's in the drop now.
Hey,
you'll get your ass popped up my mind in another place. Head hurt, ready to shoot a nigga in his fucking face. The other day, she was smiling, sitting up. Nobody but me knows how much I miss her. This for granny, 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 granny. Why you had to take me mama away? Momo, I'm going crazy. I'm all fucked up. I'm going crazy.
I'm going crazy.
I'm all
fucked
up. Granny, 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 granny. Why you had to take me mama away?